So now let's look at the whole pipeline of how we would go for an image to extract an edge image out of it. Again, an edge image would be basically showcasing where most of the contrast changes are in an image and best represents the changes in the spatial X and Y of an image like this. As we noticed before, first thing we want to do is we want to suppress noise. You want to run some sort of a smoothing operation, a blur kernel, using a Gaussian kernel to be able to get rid of some of the information, because as we noticed, the gradient image calculation is really sensitive to noise. Of course, next step is we compute the gradient image after the image has been smoothed out a little bit, and you would get something like this, where all of the intensity information, basically where the gradient is the largest, is shown by the white lines here. And this is a gradient magnitude image. Third step is we apply some sort of edge enhancement, which basically means is that we will filter this image for contrast to bring out the most value where the gradients are much, much more higher than anything else. Otherwise, if you notice, this image is basically just black and white with a lot less white. We want to bring out the white information here to actually have more local information around the whites, because we don't want to lose any information because we've just linearly looked at the space between 0 to 255. So we want to kind of enhance this data structure, which is basically an intermediate one from here to there, so we can actually start looking for edges more carefully. Next thing we want to do is we want to start localizing edges, which basically means is we need to determine which local maximum from any filter output is actually referring to edges as opposed to noise. So in essence, we want to kind of look for filter responses and start extracting it various types of ways, a differential that lets us get rid of noise and pay attention to edges. Many different methods for this exist. I recommend you to look at the text for this. I'll just showcase one of them in a bit. Finally, the last step is we want to threshold the information after we've done all of this, and also sometimes do something which is referred to as thinning, which is a morphological operator on images that basically lets you combine pixels in close by into a much more thinner representation. Because in essence, we're looking for a fine resolution image where the edges are likely to be in this image. The output, of course, is a image like this, which looks similar, but if you notice now, it's mostly just one pixels of lines everywhere. It's very hard to see because, again, the way it's represented here in black and white, but you'll see many examples of this as you do this work yourself. But this is one of the best ways to look for an edge image.